Hey guys, Dan Duran from GetCyber, and today we're going to continue on with Hack the Box, Starting Point, Learn the Basics of Penetration Testing. We are on number 5, Explosion, right here. So we're going to start right from the beginning. Let me just reset the machine. All right, so this is our IP address. And let's get going. So it's just a whole bunch of questions. We're going to be doing RDP into a Windows machine. RDP, famous or infamous protocol from Microsoft. Infamous because it gets hacked a lot. Famous because you can connect to anything you want. If you're working remotely, for example, you can connect to your machines and stuff. All right, let's get going. What does the three-letter acronym RDP stand for? That one, it should be Remote Desktop Protocol, right? So Remote Desktop Protocol, submit answer, and that is correct. What is the three-letter acronym that refers to interaction with the host through a command line interface? That'd be the CLI, command line interface, or CLI. There you go. Task number 3, what about graphical user interface? So that would be the GUI, and I'll show you what the GUI is for the remote desktop. Submit the answer. There you go. What is the name of an old remote access tool that came without encryption by default and listens on port 23? Yes, everybody should know this one is the infamous Telnet, the most insecure of protocols from the 1980s. So let's just type that down, Telnet. Submit the answer. There you go. What is the name of the service running on port 3389? And for that, we're gonna have to do a quick nmap. So let me just power up my terminal and let me just copy this IP address first. Click to copy, open up the terminal, nmap 3389 with this IP address here. Everything looks good except for the nmap. There you go, nmap. There you go, 3389 TCP open, and it's MS WBT server. All right, copy this. Let's go down, paste it in here, submit the answer. What is the switch used to specify a target host IP address when using X-free RDP? Okay, let's find that out. Let's go in here. Let me clear the screen. X-free RDP help. So these are all the commands and the different options that XRDP has, or X-free RDP. I usually use XRDP or Remnant for this type of stuff. I seldom use X-free RDP, so I'm not too sure. So if we keep going down, you'll see here, right in here, right? So slash V colon server and then port. All right, so let's use that. So X-free RDP slash V, and then, oh, let's go back and copy the IP address. There you go, paste. And I'm going to put 3389 just in case. And let's see. Perfect. Yes, for trusting the certificate, domain, password. Oh, and we got an error. All right, so let's put this down in here first. So it would be slash V and colon. Submit the answer. What username successfully returns a desktop projection to us with a blank password? Okay, so I know exactly what that is. So if you go back here, let me just clear the screen, and then we're going to do the same thing, but over here we're going to put slash u for user, and let's try administrator. There's the password, and we have a connection. Perfect. All right, so this is your typical RDP connection to a Windows machine. And you can see the flag right there. Okay, so that would be administrator, submit. All right, and let's just submit the flag, right? Here's the flag, copy and paste. And voila, easy peasy. That was super easy. You have to try different usernames, right? So I try root, I try admin, and then administrator, because administrator is a very typical admin or root user for Windows machines, right? So for Linux machines, it's usually root. For Windows machines, it's usually administrator. All right, I hope you had fun. If you have any questions, any comments, make sure you put them down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next time.